आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू ऑन द फास्ट ट्रैक डिफेंस चैनल। दोस्तों, एज इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव टोल्ड यू रिगार्डिंग द कॉल अप लेटर फॉर SSB भोपाल एंड SSB बेंगलुरु, एंड नाउ मेनी ऑफ द कैंडिडेट्स हैव मैसेज मी दैट दे वॉन्ट ए डिटेल एक्सप्लेनेशन फॉर द AFSB ऑल द बोर्ड्स कॉल अप लेटर। सो इन दिस वीडियो विच यू आर गोइंग टू सी, आई एम गोइंग टू टेक ऑल द कॉल अप लेटर फॉर AFSB 1, AFSB 2, AFSB 3, AFSB 4, AFSB 5, AFSB। सो दिस वीडियो इज गोइंग टू बी लॉन्ग, सो प्लीज हैव पेशेंस, कीप पेशेंस, बिकॉज इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू ईच एंड एवरीथिंग इन डिटेल अबाउट वॉट आर द डॉक्यूमेंट्स यू हैव टू टेक, वॉट आर द थिंग्स यू हैव टू कैरी, वेयर यू हैव टू रिपोर्ट फॉर योर SSB, एंड वॉट आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट डॉक्यूमेंट्स लाइक 10th मार्कशीट, 12th मार्कशीट, 10th सर्टिफिकेट, 12th सर्टिफिकेट, वॉट आर द क्लॉथ्स यू हैव टू कैरी, एंड वॉट आर द टेस्ट विच विल बी कंडक्टेड, एंड वॉट आर द अदर डॉक्यूमेंट्स विच आर मैंशनड इन द कॉल ऑफ लेटर लाइक इंडेमनिटी बॉन्ड एंड इवन लाइक डिक्लेरेशन फॉर्म एंड अदर फॉर्म्स विच आर mentioned in the call up letter, journey details, how you have to fill each and everything in detail I am going to tell you in this video. As you can see that the call up letter which is appearing on your screen, now I have taken this call up letter from 3 AFSB Gandhinagar and few more call up letter which will be appearing on your screen, like this call up letter is for Varanasi, for 4 AFSB Varanasi. Similarly, I have taken call up letter for Dehradun, for the Guwahati and all other AFSB board. So this video is completely dedicated for the Air Force aspirant for NDA 148 entry. Before moving ahead, I would like to ask a simple question to all of you, and the question which is appearing on your screen is, where is India's first biomass based hydrogen plant setup? So basically they are asking that recently in one of the state in India, the country's first biomass based hydrogen plant was set up. These four are your option: option A Uttar Pradesh, option B Madhya Pradesh, option C Andhra Pradesh, option C Arunachal Pradesh. If you know the answer for this question, pause the video, go on to the comment section and write your answer in the comment section. I am going to give the answer for this question in the end and also explain you in detail about the AFSB call up letter, about the documents in each and everything in detail. And if you are preparing for NDA 1 to 2022 examination, then you can follow our channel, because in our channel for the current affairs section we have already made 3 videos, and those 3 videos are very much helpful for you. It will help you to crack the current affairs portion of the NDA and as well as the CBS examination. Around 10 to 12 questions you will see in the NDA paper and around 17 to 19 questions you will see in the CDS paper from the current affairs section and only from our video. So have complete faith on us for the current affairs and stay tuned till the end. फ्रेंड्स, आगे बढ़ने से पहले आप सभी के लिए एक इंपॉर्टेंट अपडेट आया है अनअकैडमी की तरफ से। अपडेट यही है कि अगर आप NDA 2022 की प्रिपरेशन कर रहे हैं तो अनअकैडमी पे आपके लिए विजय पथ बचा है। यहाँ पे आप लिस्ट ऑफ एजुकेटर्स देख सकते हैं और ये 11th February से 30th March तक होने वाला है। सिमिलरली अनअकैडमी पे अभी एक बंपर ऑफर आया है NDA 2022 के एस्पिरेंट के लिए, जहाँ पे अगर आप 3 months का प्लस का सब्सक्रिप्शन लेते हैं तो आपको 1 month का SSB का फ्री का सब्सक्रिप्शन मिल जाएगा, और ये सिर्फ 10th और 11th February तक ही अप्लीकेबल होने वाला है। अनअकैडमी आपके लिए लाया है पैंथर क्रैश कोर्स, जो कि 9th January से 30th March तक होने वाला है, और यहाँ पे आप लिस्ट ऑफ एजुकेटर्स भी देख सकते हैं जहाँ पे आपको कंप्लीट सिलेबस कवर कराई जाएगी। सिमिलरली अगर आप MNS की प्रिपरेशन करना चाहते हैं अनअकैडमी के साथ, तो यहाँ पे भी आप लिस्ट ऑफ एजुकेटर्स देख सकते हैं, और ये 9th February से 5th April तक चलने वाला है। कंप्लीट 60 days क्रैश कोर्स नाइटिंगल MNS बैच, यहाँ पे भी आप लिस्ट ऑफ एजुकेटर्स देख सकते हैं, यहाँ पे भी आपको कंप्लीट सिलेबस कवर कराई जाएगी। उसके बाद अनअकैडमी आपके लिए लाया है आइकॉनिक सब्सक्रिप्शन, जहाँ पे आपको प्लस का फायदा तो मिलेगा ही, प्लस आपको इंडिविजुअल मेंटरशिप भी मिल जाएगा अनअकैडमी के तरफ से, और यहाँ पे आप प्राइसेस देख सकते हैं 6 month, 12 month और 24 month प्लस और आइकॉनिक दोनों के। तो फ्रेंड्स, अगर आप NDA का प्लस का सब्सक्रिप्शन लेना चाहते हैं, क्योंकि अभी NDA के सब्सक्रिप्शन पे प्राइस हाइक होने वाला है, तो यहाँ पे आप प्राइसेस देख सकते हैं 24 month, 12 month, 6 month, 3 month और 1 month के। ये प्राइसेस आपको कंप्लीटली पे नहीं करने हैं, पे करने से पहले आपसे एक रेफरल कोड मांगा जाएगा। उस रेफरल कोड में आप सिंपली FD10 टाइप करेंगे तो आपको 10% का एडिशनल डिस्काउंट मिल जाएगा अनअकैडमी के सारे कोर्सेस पे। और अगर आप एयरफोर्स, नेवी या फिर कोस्ट गार्ड की प्रिपरेशन कर रहे हैं, तो यहाँ भी आपको कंप्लीट प्राइसेस पे नहीं करने हैं, पे करने से पहले आपको एक कोड मांगा जाएगा। यहाँ पे आपको FD10 टाइप करेंगे तो 10% का एडिशनल डिस्काउंट मिल जाएगा अनअकैडमी के सभी कोर्सेज पे। और इस दोनों कोर्स का लिंक मैंने वीडियो के डिस्क्रिप्शन में दे दिया हूं, आप वहां से जाके अनअकैडमी के साइट पे रजिस्टर कर सकते हैं। सो फ्रेंड्स, कमिंग बैक टू द मेन टॉपिक ऑफ द वीडियो रिगार्डिंग द डिटेल एक्सप्लेनेशन, डिटेल एनालिसिस ऑफ द AFSB SSB call up letter for the Air Force board, that is for the 1 FSB, 2 FSB, 3, 4 and 5 FSB at various centers which are situated all across the country. And the PDF which is appearing on your screen, this PDF I have taken from 3 FSB Gandhinagar. So I am going to tell you how you have to fill the SSB call up letter forms, because still many of the candidates are confused about the journey details. Should they give their father bank account number, father IFSC code, or should they few more doubts in the declaration form, few more doubts in the candidate questionnaire are still coming up. So I am going to solve each and every queries whatever you have at the back of your mind. So stay tuned, keep patience and stay tuned in this video till the end. So as you are seeing the call-up letter, this call-up letter is for Air Force candidate for NDA 148 entry for 3 FSB Gandhinagar. So basically in the starting, they have, you have to fill your roll number here and your name here and your details here, that means your father name, mother name, date of birth, identification mark and your address. And one more thing I want to tell you, like if you see the Air Force call-up letter for the Gandhinagar or for the Dehradun or for the Mysore, most of the call-up letters are similar. So the thing which I will explain you for the 3 AFSB Gandhinagar, same thing is going to be for the Dehradun, Varanasi, Mysore and other AFSB as well. But at the end I would show you all the call-up letters, and if there is any kind of unique form for any particular board, then that unique form will be explained by me in the upcoming stages. So this is for the AFSB Gandhinagar. This is the place where you have to report. Reporting point ST Depot Sector 11 Gandhinagar, inside the Pratik Ashram bus stand towards the right side of the entrance gate. That means basically you are asked to report at the Pratik Ashram bus stand in Gandhinagar. And if you have any of the doubt, you can mail them at this mail ID. These things you have to note down. Then next important instructions is starting from this place. This is the place where you have to report, that is Sector 11 Gandhinagar, inside the Pratik Ashram bus stand on the right side of the entrance gate, by time is 6:30 morning. That means by 6:30 am on the particular date which you have selected, on that day you have to report for your AFSB NDA 148 course. And one more thing is that you have to carry your face shield, N95 mask. This both is compulsory, as you can see that this is mentioned in the bold letter. So you have to carry your own face shield and face mask. And another thing is that in the addition, before reporting to the board, you must familiarize yourself and follow the latest instructions, norms. So basically they are saying you to follow all the instructions and all. And now the important point come about, what are the documents, what are the IDs or what are the certificates which you have to carry for your AFSB. So these things, the point number 5, which is very much important, you must bring the following documents in original along with 3 photocopies of the same. So what are the documents which you have to carry? The first document is 10th standard passing certificate and mark sheet, both. If you see the mark sheet and certificate for CBSE, those who have done their 10th standard from the CBSE board, mark sheet is different and passing certificate is different. But in the case of state board, mark sheet and passing certificate both are same. So here don't get confused that you have to carry separate mark sheet and separate passing certificate. If both are same, if both the documents are same, like in the top of the document, if it is mentioned mark sheet come certificate, then both the documents are same only, you don't need to carry separately. But in case of CBSE, both are separate, so you have to carry your 10th mark sheet and certificate separately. Similarly, in the case of 12th standard as well, your 12th standard original mark sheet and certificate and 3 copies of each, 10th mark sheet, 10th certificate, 12th mark sheet, 12th certificate. Next thing is that NCC C certificate, if you have got any NCC certificate, you can carry them as well. Then you have to carry your admit card, your UPSC admit card, then your photo ID card, that includes your driving license or passport or voter ID card or Aadhaar card. Most preferably I would tell you to carry Aadhaar card only, because you used Aadhaar card only for the Join Indian Army registration, so Aadhaar card is going to be the best one. Next important thing is that you have to carry 25 recent color photograph. So this photograph you have to carry and preferably in the light background, because once you enter into the board campus, you will not be allowed to go outside for any of the documents. So you have to make a plan, make an arrangement. You have to organize yourself in such a way that you, once you report to the AFSB, be it Gandhinagar, Dehradun, Varanasi, Mysore or anywhere else, you should have all the documents ready so that you are not cared about the documents and your focus is completely on the particular test which is to be held. Next thing is that on a paper you have to write name, telephone number and complete postal address of the two trustworthy person or gazetted officer, and this person should know your vouch of character and antecedent. That means basically what they are trying to say in this line is that you have to like other than your parents, other than your father and mother, you have to get verified by two person. That two person can be your relative as well, like they can be your uncle or they can be your neighbor as well. So you have to get their address, their name, and that person must know you, that yes, you both are known to each other. In this way you have to get signed in your particular A4 sheet. Next thing is that for the candidates who are studying in the 12th standard, for the candidates, those who are studying in the 12th standard in the current year of the academic year, he should bring a bona fide certificate from the principal of the institute. A specimen copy is annexed. That means one annexure is already there in this form, and that form you have to fill and bring it in the SSB center. Next important instruction is for the traveling allowances. For the traveling allowances, the important instruction is that if you are traveling through railways or bus ticket or airways, you must have the original ticket. Then only you will be given the traveling allowances for both coming journey and as well as returning journey. No traveling allowances will be paid without hard copy of the ticket, journey and account details. So basically they are trying to say that you have to carry the original hard copy of the ticket. Like you cannot show them on the phone that yes, this is my ticket, this is my passport or whatever it is, or this is my travel pass. They are not going to accept. You have to carry the original hard copy of the ticket and your account number, and that account number you can take the print out of the first page of the account number. Then only they are going to pay you the journey particular journey amount. If you are below 18 years of age, the indemnity bond should be signed by your father or the natural guardian. So basically there is an indemnity bond which is attached in this call-up letter only. When you are filling that indemnity bond, you have to get signed by your parents if you are below 18 years of age. I will tell you that what is that indemnity bond. Next thing is that undertaking for willingness and unwillingness for Air Force ground duty is also attached below to be signed by the parents, guardian if the candidate is below 18 years of age, and this is mandatory. That means the undertaking for willingness certificate, there is a willingness certificate which is attached in this call-up letter that I will show you later, that you have to get signed, and that is mandatory. If you are below 18 years, your parent has to sign. If you are above 18 years, you have to sign in that willingness certificate. So this also you have to fill. Next thing, they have told you to carry the one pair of white shirt, t-shirt, shorts or trousers, tracksuit, socks, a pair of sports shoes, bring at least one pair of the formal dress shoes for interview purpose. So clothings are mentioned here, that what are the clothes you have to bring for the interview, for the GTO and other tasks which are conducted. Then next thing is that candidates with present backlog in class 12 standard need not report, as they will be routed back. So if you have taken backlog for class 12, you should not attend the SSB. That means basically they are trying to say that if you are in 11th standard and if you have appeared in the UPSC examination and if you have cleared, then even if you report to the SSB, you will be routed back, you will be not assessed. So if you are presently in the 11th standard, or if you are going to give 11th standard final examination, or about to go to 12th standard, then you should not attend the SSB even if you have cleared the UPSC examination. Next thing, they have talked about the selection process. So your selection is going to be held in two phases. Phase 1 consists of PP and DT, and phase 2 consists of phase 1 consists of PP and DT and OIR. So once you clear the phase 1, you will be directed for the phase 2, and phase 2 consists of your GTO interview, psychology test and finally the conference. So your day 2, day 3 and day 4 will be completely of the phase 2, and in that phase 2 group task interview will be conducted within this timing only, and psychological test will be conducted on the first day itself. So this point you have to note down. If you are going for the AFSB, your psychology test is held on the same date on which day you report itself, that is phase 2. Like, as soon as the screening result will come, the guys who are screened out, they will be routed back, and those who are screened in, they will be allotted the rooms, and they will be given around 2 to 3 hours of resting period. And after 2 to 3 hours of resting period, they will have their psychology test, that is phase 2, from 16 hours to 19 hours. That means from 4 o'clock to 7 o'clock, these 3 hours of timing, you will have your psychology test. And day 2, day 3, day 4, you will go through group tasks and interviews. And finally, on the day 5, you will have your conference. And those who are recommended, they will have their CPSS test, that is called pilot test. CPSS stands for Computerized Pilot Selection System. So, routed to the 2 AFSB Mysore for the CPSS test, that means whose center is in Gandhinagar. Because in Gandhinagar there is no facility for the CPSS test, so they will be directed to the 2 AFSB Mysore immediately after their SSB, immediately after their recommendation. Next thing is for the dresses. What are the dress you have to wear? For group task, you have to have one pair of white shoe. Here white shoe is written, so you should not carry any kind of color shoes or any other thing. White shoe, t-shirt, shorts, trouser, tracksuit, socks and a pair of sports shoes. Candidates are advised to carry adequate clothing to cater for restricted laundry services. So these things you have to take care. Similarly, for the interview, two pair of formal dress. They have asked you to carry two pair of formal dress. One pair you are going to use for the interview purpose, and another pair you are going to use for the conference day. So it is going to be plain light color t-shirt with or without tie. That means tie is optional. If you want to use tie, you can use tie, otherwise it's your choice. And dark color trouser, that means shirt should be light color and the pant which you are going to wear, that should be dark color. So this is for the interview purpose. And for the mess, you must carry some formal dress, like you can carry lower, or you can carry some t-shirt, or if it is winter, then you can carry clothings as per the winter requirement as well. Then liberty, if you talk about the liberty, what will be there? Liberty means going out of the premises of the AFSB, formal dress, casual decent dress, medium size lock for the safeguard of your personal luggage. However, presently candidates will not be allowed to go out of the board during the period of the COVID-19. So liberty means you are not given any kind of liberty to go outside of the selection system or the selection gate because of the COVID-19 restriction. Next thing is for the interview. Note for the interview that all the candidates are to be prepared for a separate folder for the interview, neatly marked, and name and roll number comprising of all the original educational certificate, mark sheets, certificate of the excellence, achievements, co-curricular activities or any other documents deemed fit by the candidate for the interviews. So basically what they are trying to say in this paragraph, this paragraph talks that, like, let's say your interview is fixed on a day at around 2 p.m. Then by 1 p.m. you have to be reported there, and by 1:30 p.m. you must carry one file, and in that file all your mark sheet, 10th mark sheet, 10th certificate, 12th mark sheet, 12th certificates, or if you have any kind of extra curricular achievement certificate, like if you have represented your school or your college in inter-school sports competition or any kind of extracurricular activities. That means if you have any kind of certificate, carry all the certificate, put them in the file. That file will be taken to the interviewing officer before your interview will be taken. So this thing you have to note down. Next thing is for the boarding and lodging. Free boarding and lodging will be provided only to the candidate at the board for a period of testing. So only for the candidate, those who are being tested, only for them free boarding and lodging will be provided. So you don't need to worry about where to stay or where to have food and all. For the candidates, those who are being tested, like if a candidate who is being screened out on the first day, they will be routed back. For them, there will not be any kind of fooding and lodging provided at the center even for one day. So these things you have to take care. Then for the traveling allowances, by the shortest route for the AC 3 tire express train bus to and fro journey from the place of the call up or the departure, you must furnish the hard copy of the railway ticket, bus ticket, air ticket. This I already told you in the starting that you must carry the hard copy of the tickets which you are using for the traveling and hard copy of the passbook which you have, so that your traveling allowances will be given, and the traveling allowances for the both incoming journey and outgoing journey, both the journey will be given in that particular bank account. Next thing is for the medical examination. So if you are clearing the SSB, recommended candidate will be required to proceed for the Air Force Central Medical Establishment New Delhi or Institute of Air Force Medicine Bangalore or MH Bhopal for the medical examination during 4 to 7 days. So basically they are trying to say that if you are being recommended, then for the medical examination you will not be medically tested in the Gandhinagar itself or in the particular Air Force Board itself. You will be given a particular date, and in that day you have to report to either New Delhi or to the Bangalore or MH Bhopal, that means Military Hospital Bhopal. So wherever you are given the particular date and time and location, at that point of time you have to report for your medical examination. If not meeting the eligibility criteria as given in the advertisement website, you shall be returned from the selection board without testing and reimbursement of the TA. So basically they are trying to say that you must fulfill the criteria, like your age limit should be within the notification which came. If you are not fulfilling the criteria, you will not be tested in the particular AFSB, and even your traveling allowances will not be given for that period of time. Then this discipline and general rules, these are not important for you. Then warning and all, this is not important for you. Next important point is that these are the documents which you have to carry, and you have to get at least one copy of this document after filling them. First one is declaration form, then it is candidate questionnaire, then journey particulars, then indemnity bond, willingness certificate, bona fide certificate, and a candidate for self-certification of the COVID-19 and advisory for the COVID-19. This thing you have to fill. And basically now they have given a list of documents which you have to carry and which is mandatory and which is not mandatory. So first one is call-up letter. So filling up of the call-up letter is very much mandatory. Then you must have Arogya Setu app installed in your phone. That is again mandatory. Vaccination certificate for RT-PCR. Negative report within 72 hours prior to the reporting. So basically they are trying to say that you must have either vaccination certificate for both the dose. Like if someone has taken the vaccination certificate for both the doses, either Covishield or Covaxin, but both the doses, and you have the vaccination certificate generated by the Cowin platform, then you no need to carry RT-PCR report. But if you don't have vaccination certificate, then in that case you must carry RT-PCR report within 72 hours of reporting. This thing you have to take care, and this is again mandatory. Next one is admit card of UPSC NDA, that is again mandatory. Next thing is original and the photocopies of your 10th and 12th standard mark sheet and certificate. Again, this both are mandatory. Then original photocopy of NCC certificate. If you have any kind of NCC certificate, then you can carry them as well. That must be original. Original and photocopy of ID card. That means if you are carrying any ID card like Aadhaar card or driving license, you must bring original and a photocopy of them. Name and address of two trusted officer. This already I told you, like you must get name and complete address of the two trustworthy person. Any of them, that two can be either your neighbor or your uncle, but that person must know you personally. Next thing is that original and photocopy of the ID proof, this already I told you. Then 25 recent passport size photograph, this is again mandatory. Then your journey particulars should be filled, and your bank account name and your bank details must be filled accurately as per the passbook. This is again mandatory. Next thing is that print out of all the forms in para 14 should be in the A4 size form. That means whatever print out you are taking, that print out should be taken in the A4 size form only. A4 sheet only, and this is again mandatory. Then undertaking certificate is mandatory, indemnity bond is mandatory, willingness certificate is mandatory. So these were all the instructions, documents which you have to carry. Now I am going to tell you the documents how you have to fill. So the first document which is coming on your screen is form of indemnity bond. Ab many of them will have doubt that why this document is being filled. This document is being filled like while testing, if you have got any kind of injury, or if you have got any kind of some kind of injury or some kind of problem, then you will not be like, you cannot approach to some police station or court and you cannot blame the Air Force. So for that you must fill this form of indemnity bond. And here chest number 1 and chest number 2, why they have asked you to fill? Because before screening you will be given one chest number, and after screening you will be given another chest number. So basically you have to fill your name here, and after that if you come down you have to fill the date, day, then sign of the witness. That means you have to get signature of one witness, and here the signature of the candidate and signature of the guardian or your parents. This you can take. And next one is one more thing which they have mentioned here in terms of note. Candidate who are below 18 years of age with incomplete indemnity bond will be routed back. That means if you are below 18 years of age and attending the SSB, then your indemnity bond should be completely filled as per the requirement. Requirement is that you must get the sign of the parents here, like you cannot sign yourself here, and signature of the witness can be anyone, like your neighbor or your uncle or anyone. There is no issue with that. Next thing is declaration form. Declaration form is also important for the AFSB candidate. Even if you take the one AFSB Dehradun or two AFSB Mysore or any other AFSB, in every AFSB you are given a declaration form. In declaration form you have to fill your particular personal details, like here the chest number phase 1, chest number phase 2. That means before screening what was your chest number, after screening what was your chest number. Then your name of the kin, that means your father name, and what is the relation with you. Like if you are filling your father name here, then you have to type here father, contact number. Then next thing is that you have to tick here, like if you have body tattoo then you have to tick yes, if you don't have body tattoo then you have to tick no. If you are in the armed forces already, then you have to tick yes, otherwise no. Similarly, if you have studied in the signing school or military school or RIMC, then you have to tick as per the requirement. Otherwise, you can tick for no or you can leave it blank. If you have studied in the signing school, then you can tick on the signing school and write the name of the signing school here. Similarly, you have to fill your roll number here. Then batch number should be filled here. Then date of birth, name as per 10th standard certificate. Then your marks in 12th standard. Then if you have taken any backlog, as per that you can tick yes or no. Or if you are wearing specs, then you can tick as per yes or no. Similarly, the next form is for screened out and repeaters. Like if anyone is attending SSB for the second time, third time, fourth time, then for them this is the form. If you have appeared SSB for Army, Navy or Air Force earlier, if you have appeared you have to tick yes. If you haven't appeared then no. And if you haven't appeared, if this SSB is going to be the first SSB, then you don't need to fill this form. But if you have appeared for SSB earlier, then you have to fill up the details of the previous SSB, like your previous chest number, your previous batch number, the previous place and date, what was the name of the entry, what was the result, whether you got screened out or conference out or you were recommended, how many days you stayed in the SSB. Each and every details you have to fill for the screened out and repeaters only. Next thing is, this is only for the candidates, those who have appeared in the CPSS earlier. If you have appeared in the CPSS, that means pilot test earlier, then you have to fill this. Otherwise, you don't need to fill this. Like if you have appeared in the CPSS earlier, you can fill yes, and you can give the details of the batch number, chest number, AFSB center, date. If you have passed, then you can tick on pass. If fail, means you can tick on fail. And similarly, your sign should be there, your phone number should be there, and you can tick the entry in which entry you cleared the CPSS, either in the ND entry or the TS entry. In this way, you can do. So this was till the declaration form and for the screen out and repeater form. Next form is journey particulars. Journey particulars is very much important. You have to give each and every details very carefully, because journey details you are going to get the money which you spent for booking ticket, both the money in incoming journey as well as outgoing journey, both the journey entire money you are going to get back. And this journey particular is only for the fresher candidate. Like if you are going to SSB for the first time, then only you have to fill the journey details. Like you have to fill your roll number here, batch number here, name here, address here, then your nearest railway station here. Similarly, your amount you have to fill here. Like if you have traveled through bus, air or train, then automatically you have to tick as per the choice and fill the amount, your PNR number of the ticket. Same thing you have to fill here. Then your account number here, bank name, IFSC code, branch, each and everything you have to give as per the your account number which is there in your passbook, as per the passbook. Next thing is that please attach a cancelled check or a photocopy of the first page of your bank passbook. Like if you have any passbook in which you want the money to get back, that first page of the passbook you must get printed somewhere and attached with this form, with this journey particulars. And at the end you have to sign here, and your mobile number should be there and your date should be here. So this thing you can take care. Next important thing is candidate questionnaire. This candidate questionnaire you are going to fill about you. Like basically this kind of candidate questionnaire is everything about your biodata, like from where you did schooling, where is your address, who are there in your parents, each and everything is there. So basically first one is about the personal details, your batch number, your name, roll number, date of birth, height in centimeter and weight in kg. So basically you have to fill height in centimeter, don't fill like 1.7. like if you are 170 centimeter, don't fill like 1.7 meter. You have to fill in centimeter and weight in kg. Similarly you have to fill your entry detail, like for which entry you are going, that you have to fill here. Next thing is that you have to fill your address, where you stayed for the maximum time and where you are staying presently, that means your permanent address, your place, district and state. Then about your education background is next. Like if you have done your 10th standard with CBSE board, you just tick on the CBSE and just fill up the percentage. Or if you have got any kind of division, fill here. If you have studied in the Saini school, RIMC or any other government school, then based on that you have to tick there. Like if you have studied in the Saini school, then you can tick this Saini school. Next thing is for 12th standard, same thing for the 12th standard as well. You have to fill your percentage here, division here, and tick your particular board. Next thing is that candidate employment details. Like if you are working, let's say if you are a working candidate, then you have to fill your detail here. Like which job you are doing and what is your monthly income here in the proper amount. Next thing is for the NCC experience. Like if you had been NCC in the school times, or at present if you are in NCC during the college time, then you can give the details of the NCC here as well. And if you have got any certificate, like A certificate, B certificate, C certificate, just you can mention here, you can tick on the particular things. Next thing is about the parents and guardian detail. Like if your father is some job, doing some job within this, then you have to write the job here. And after that, what is your father qualification. If your mother is doing some kind of job, then you can write the job here and your education qualification of the mother, your guardian job and your guardian education qualification. Next thing is that previous number of attempts. That means if you are repeater, if you have given any other number of SSB earlier, then you have to fill here. And next thing is that how you came to know about the Air Force, you have to tick here. Like you came to know from the school, then you have to tick here. If you came to know from the newspaper advertisement, you have to tick here. Next thing is that have you ever seen induction publicity exhibition vehicle, if yes or no. Like if you have seen any kind of bus which is promoting the Indian Air Force, if you have seen, just tick. Or if you want to give any kind of suggestion, you can give here, otherwise it is not required. And you have to sign here, date, this thing has to be filled. That means this candidate questionnaire is basically they are trying to get your basic biodata, your education qualification, your family background, your achievements, each and everything they are going to get in this candidate questionnaire only. Like you can say that this candidate questionnaire is a kind of PIG form which you fill in the SSB. नेक्स्ट थिंग इज बोनाफाइड सर्टिफिकेट. दिस बोनाफाइड सर्टिफिकेट यू हैव टू फिल योर नेम हियर, योर फादर नेम, योर स्कूल नेम, इन विच क्लास यू आर स्टडिंग, एंड वॉट आर द सर्टिफिकेट्स यू हैवेंट ब्रॉट. सो दिस बोनाफाइड सर्टिफिकेट इज ओनली फॉर द कैंडिडेट्स दोस हु आर इन द प्रेजेंट 12th स्टैंडर्ड एंड दे आर नॉट हैविंग 12th स्टैंडर्ड पासिंग सर्टिफिकेट एंड 12th स्टैंडर्ड मार्कशीट. बिकॉज इफ दे आर इन प्रेजेंट 12th स्टैंडर्ड दे हैवेंट गिवन द 12th स्टैंडर्ड एग्जामिनेशन. सो इन दैट केस यू हैव टू फिल दिस बोनाफाइड सर्टिफिकेट गिविंग ऑल द डिटेल्स एंड इन दिस ए बी सी कॉलम यू हैव टू राइट विच डॉक्यूमेंट यू हैवेंट ब्रॉट. लाइक यू कैन राइट हियर 12th स्टैंडर्ड मार्कशीट, 12th स्टैंडर्ड पासिंग सर्टिफिकेट, और इफ यू हैवेंट ब्रॉट सम अदर सर्टिफिकेट यू कैन जस्ट राइट हियर एंड जस्ट यू कैन मेंशन हियर व्हाट इज द एक्सपेक्टेड डेट टू द फाइनल रिजल्ट. लाइक इफ यू लाइक फॉर द सीबीएसई स्टिल द डेट अनाउंसमेंट हैजंट कम, सो यू कैन इवन लीव दिस ब्लैंक, देयर इज नो इश्यू विद दैट. एंड सिग्नेचर ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल विथ पर्टिकुलर स्टाम्प हैज टू बी मेंशन हियर एंड योर पर्टिकुलर प्लेस एंड डेट हैज टू बी मेंशन हियर. Next thing is this are the instruction how you have to fill the indemnity bond. This and all I already explained you, so you don't need to worry about this one. Next important thing for you all is this one, willingness certificate for the NDA candidate. So why they are asking you to fill this willingness certificate? Like if you have got recommended for the SSB but you haven't cleared the CPSS test, and if they are allotting you ground duty, then are you interested in the ground duty? Are you willing to take a ground duty? Then in that case, you have to fill this form. You have to give your name here, UPSC roll number here, which entry you belong to, 2020-21 you have to write here. Then next thing is that in the end, you have to, if you are below 18 years, then your parents has to sign, and if you are above 18 years, you have to sign by your own. And another important thing which you have to tick here, like if you are willing to take the ground duty, then in that case you have to tick on the willing. If you are not willing to take ground duty, you have to tick on unwilling. So based on your choice, you can tick whatever is your choice. Like if you haven't cleared the CPSS test and you can even work on the ground duty, you can tick the ground duty willingness. But if you don't want to work in the ground duty, you can tick on the unwillingness. This is as per your choice. And signature, if you are below 18, your parents has to sign. If you are above 18, you have to sign by your own. Next thing is for the self-certification of the COVID-19 for the Gandhinagar board. Same thing is there for the other boards like Dehradun and other board as well. Your name should be there, your batch number, roll number, that means UPSC roll number, date of birth. Mode of travel, you can tick in which mode you are traveling, like railways, roadways, airways. So in that way, you can tick state of start of the journey, that means date, and when you arrive on the 3 FSB, where you stayed in the journey. Like if your center is Gandhinagar, then you might have stayed in you might have got down in the Ahmedabad railway station, or you might have stayed in the Pratik Ashram bus stand near some lodge and all. Those things you can mention here, your phone number, and all the places which you have been visited last to 21 days, this everything you have to mention. And next thing is that, like if you have got any kind of symptom for cold, cough, fever, then in that case you can fill and you can tick as per the choice. Like if you have got any kind of cough or any other kind of symptom, based on that you can tick yes or no. If you have visited any COVID center, then based on that you can tick yes or no. And at the end, you must sign yourself. If you are above 18, then you have to sign by your own. But if you are below 18, that this signature has to be there. Your parents' signature should be there in this place. Next thing is advisory for the COVID-19. In the advisory for the COVID-19, you have to sign here. And your phone number has to be written. And your particular date has to be written. So with this, we have come to the end of the AFSB Gandhinagar. But last form is undertaking certificate. This undertaking certificate says that my son will not claim Air Force ground duty if I am unfit for the Air Force flying branch due to medical my preference at the time of the order. Like let's say if you are being recommended for the Air Force and if you haven't cleared the CPSS and you are allotted army, then in that case, if you are not willing to go to army, then in that case you have to fill the willingness certificate which I told you earlier. But in this case, let's say if your rank is low and you are not given Air Force, you are given a service of their choice, like if you are given Army or Navy, then in that case this certificate will be worthful. Here you have to write your signature of the name or the signature of the candidate or the signature of the parents. If you are below 18, signature of the parents. If you are above 18, signature of the candidate. Name of the candidate, relationship of the candidate. Then after that, UPSC roll number, batch number, SSB, center, place and date. So with this, we have come end to the call-up letter for the Gandhinagar. And now we will move to the call-up letter for the Mysore. And in Mysore also, same thing is there. Only few things which are going to change. Here the important changes is like where you have to report. You have to report at the 2 AFSB Mysore, Chamundi, Vihar Complex, Nandini, Milk, Dairy, Siddharth Nagar, Mysore, and this is your pin code. So this is the place where you have to report. And otherwise all the instructions, whatever I told you for the Gandhinagar, all the instructions are same. Here also they have told that you should be mandatorily in the possession of double face mask, N95 mask. If you have taken the vaccination for both the dose, then you no need to carry the RT-PCR report. But if you haven't taken, then you must carry RT-PCR report. This is mandatory. Otherwise, all the instructions are same. Like here, what are the things you have to carry? 10th, 12th mark sheet, 10th, 12th certificate. Then about all the certificates of extracurricular activities, sports activities which you have taken part, 25 recent color photograph. All the instructions are same. So the instruction which is different in this Mysore, if it is there, I would explain you in the detail. This is again advisory is again same like Gandhinagar only. Then form of indemnity is again like Gandhinagar only. Then this declaration form for the repeater is again like Gandhinagar only. Journey particular is same like Gandhinagar. Bona fide certificate same like Gandhinagar only. Candidate questionnaire again same like Gandhinagar only. And again willingness certificate again same like Gandhinagar only. Next undertaking same like Gandhinagar only. And these are the instructions. So here 3 AFSB Gandhinagar and 2 AFSB Mysore. Both the call-up letters are almost same. So next I'll take the call-up letter for the Guwahati, 5 AFSB Guwahati. For this 5 AFSB Guwahati, again you have to report at this place by 6:30 in the morning, that is 11 ASC VIP Chowk, Borger, Guwahati, Assam, at 6:30 in the morning. This is the reporting location and reporting timing which is already mentioned in your call-up letter. In that particular place only you have to report. And these are the important documents which you have to carry for the SSB, like 10th mark sheet, 10th passing certificate in original, 12th mark sheet, 12th passing certificate, and CC certificate. That means whatever documents I told you for the 3 AFSB Gandhinagar, 2 AFSB Mysore, same certificates and same documents they have asked here as well. So again same thing, if you are below 18 years, your father has to sign, or your father or mother has to sign the indemnity bond. But if you are above 18 years, you can yourself sign the indemnity bond. Next important thing, again here they have given the selection process like phase 1, phase 2, how it will be conducted and timing, these things are given. So you can read the call-up letter by your own and understand the important points and where you have to report, when the test will be conducted, what are the documents you have to fill. These things you can do by your own. And again the indemnity bond is same here for the Guwahati board. Then declaration form, then this repeater form, journey particulars is again same. Then next is for the candidate questionnaire is again same. After the candidate questionnaire, willingness certificate is again same for this case as well. Then this is self certified for the COVID-19, this is again same. You can read all the instructions and just you can fill up the form for the 5 AFSB Guwahati as well. Similarly, advisory for the COVID-19. Then next is 5 AFSB Guwahati willingness undertaking certificate. And here undertaking certificate, why they are asking you to fill, like my son will not take in the Air Force ground duty. This already I explained to you, like if you are not allotted Air Force and if you are allotted Army or Navy, you have to accept that particular force, particular service if your ranking is low. So for that only they are asking you to fill. If you are below 18, your parent has to sign. If you are above 18, you have to sign. Then next is bona fide certificate, like if you have submitted 10th and 12th marksheet in the college, or if you haven't got 12th standard marksheet, if you are appearing 12th, then you have to fill this and get signed from the principal with the stamp. Then next is these all are the documents which you have to carry: call up letter, original admit card of the UPSC, 10th marksheet and certificate, 12th marksheet and certificate, bona fide certificate. These all call up letter, whatever I have told you for the Gandhinagar, same thing is mentioned here as well. Once you can go through the complete call up letter instructions of the every board, every batch, whatever is there as per you, which you have selected during the date selection link, and you can just follow all the guidelines. And coming over to the next call up letter. Next call-up letter is for the Dehradun board, that is for the 1 AFSB Dehradun. If you talk about 1 AFSB Dehradun, again you have to report at main gate 1 AFSB Clement Town Dehradun between 6 hours to 6:30 hours. Again, reporting timing is again same like 3 AFSB Gandhinagar or 2 AFSB Mysore, between 6 to 6:30. Then these are the documents which you have to carry, like 10th and 12th marksheet and certificate, UPSC admit card, ID card, then passport size photograph. These all things, whatever is mentioned in the instruction, you have to carry each and everything. Then next, these are the forms you have to fill, like indemnity bond, declaration form, journey, willingness, questionnaire, self-certified, COVID-19 undertaking, bona fide document, body tattoo advisory, profile, body tattoo checklist for the check for the NDA 148. So most of the documents for all the AFSBs are same only. So here again the same thing, important instructions for the COVID-19 you can see here. Then after that, these are the instructions which you have to follow during the SSB. Then the questionnaire, how you have to fill. Next thing is your journey particular, this is again like same. Then indemnity bond again is same, like declaration form again same. Next, questionnaire again same. Next one is willingness certificate again same. Then for the 1 AFSB Dehradun self certified for the COVID-19, this you have to fill. This is again similar to that only which I told you earlier, advisory for the COVID-19. Undertaking certificate again it is same. Then bona fide certificate, like if you have submitted your 10th and 12th standard marksheet in the college for higher studies, or if you haven't appeared in the 12th board exam, then in that case you have to fill this bona fide certificate mentioning all the certificate. Then document undertaking for NDA 148, this you have to fill. This is again same. Next is profile of the student. Then here you have to give your all details, like where you belong to, what is your contact number, what is your email ID. This thing you have to fill here. This is like candidate questionnaire only. Then self certification for each tattoo. Here they have given one separate form for the AFSB Dehradun, that is for the tattoo. Like if you have got any kind of body tattoo in your body anywhere, then in that case you have to fill this form. What this form says, that you have to fill your name here, father name here, date of birth, then which place you belong to and which tribe you belong to. Like if you are an ST candidate and if you have any kind of tattoo, then your tribe name, your area of the state, this thing you have to fill. And at the end you have to fix a passport size photograph. Like if you have one tattoo, then one photograph here. If you have got more than one tattoo, then first photograph here, second photograph here. And you have to give the details of the tattoo, like what is the size of the tattoo, in which language the tattoo is mentioned, what is the significance of the tattoo, where is the location of the tattoo. Like if you have got tattoo in the hand, in the leg, or in the chest, or anywhere else, then in that case you have to give the details of the tattoo. Then at last you have to sign name, entry, batch number. Batch number you will be allotted after you report to the SSB. Then place and date you can give as per your choice. Next thing is certification for the candidate of each tattoo for the permanent body tattoo in respect of the candidate from the tribal communities. This is again, if you have got tattoo, then based on that, like I explained in the previous slide, same thing you can see here also. Fix the passport size photograph. If you have got more than two tattoo, then third photo here, fourth photo here, and detail of the tattoo here. These are the things. The next one is that if you are from the non-tribal community and if you have tattoo, If you are from the non-tribal community and if you have the tattoo, then in that case you have to fill here your photograph of the tattoo and details of the tattoo here, mentioning the location, mentioning the size, and mentioning the language in which the tattoo is mentioned. And in the end, you have your badge number, chest number. These are the documents which you have to carry, like call-up letter, Arogya Setu, admit card, 10th and 12th mark sheet, details, NCC certificate, name of the trustworthy person, 25 color photograph. So these things you have to carry based on the requirement. So with this, we have completed the call-up letter and we are left with the last call-up letter. Last call-up letter is for AFSB Varanasi, for AFSB Varanasi. This call-up letter is again similar to the previous four call-up letter which I just showed you. Basically, you have to report in the Varanasi at C. For AFSB Bangalore, number 47, 200 meters from the main gate of 4 AFSB towards the railway station before PNU club. So this is the reporting point of 4 AFSB Varanasi. And this is the important instructions for the COVID-19, like you have to have your own mask, gloves, sanitizer, these things and all. Then your certificate, like 10th and 12th mark sheet and certificate, admit card, then photo ID card, Aadhaar card. Then if you have got any kind of achievement certificate, then your photograph, passport size photograph, then indemnity bond declaration form. These are things you have to fill. Whatever I told you in the previous four call-up letter, everything is same. Like here, self-certified undertaking for the COVID-19, again same thing. Then next one is advisory for the COVID-19, again advisory is again same thing which I told you earlier. Indemnity bond is again same. If you are below 18 years, just get signed from your parents. If you are above 18 years, you can sign by your own. There is no issue with that. But this is compulsory. If you are not getting signed from your parents, if you are below 18, you will not be tested. You will be routed back from the SSB board. Then it is declaration form. Next, we have got journey particulars. Then it is bona fide certificate, same. Candidate questionnaire is same. Willingness certificate is same, like I told you earlier. Undertaking certificate is same. Profile of the student, like they are again asking you about all the details about your name here, what is your gender, your contact number, email ID, category, like in what you have done, what is your education qualification, like if you are doing graduation, you can write here pursuing graduation. If you have done 12th standard, you can write 12th standard completed. Then your message will be, then your date. So this thing you can fill by reading the call-up letter. And here again they have given the body tattoo. If you have got any kind of body tattoo, if you are a tribal candidate or if you are non-tribal candidate, but if you have got tattoo, then you have to fill this form by mentioning your name, your father name, and photograph of the tattoo here. This you have to fill, and at the end the signature of the candidate, place and date, this thing should be done. And these are the instructions of the call-up letter. So I think with this we have come to the end of the video. I have explained you each and everything in detail about all the AFSB, starting from the 1 AFSB Dehradun to the 5 AFSB Guwahati. Each and every board is explained by me in detail, how to fill the forms, how, where you have to report, what are the things you have to carry. Still, if you have got any kind of confusion, any kind of doubt, you can ask your doubt in the comment section. I will reply to each and every doubt. So friends, coming back to the question which I had asked you in the starting of the video, and the question was, where is India's first biomass based hydrogen plant setup? And these four were your options. So the correct answer for this question is option B, Madhya Pradesh. If you had thought that Madhya Pradesh is the correct answer, then you are right. So friends, this is the end of the video. If you have any doubt about the AFSB, any call-up letter or SSB call-up letter or NSB call-up letter or the girl candidate call-up letter, you can ask your doubt in the comment section. I will take all of the doubts. If you are preparing for NDA 1 2022 examination, then you can watch our current affairs full playlist, which is given in the playlist. You can go to the playlist and watch them. So this was the end of the video. I hope all of you enjoyed the video. Thank you friends for tuning till the end. Thank you.